Whatever we do, whatever stunts, whatever fights, everything is messy. Very messy, as if it were real life. A lot of that falls on Blake. That messiness, to sell it, to sell that she doesn't know what she's doing, but still somehow get it done by the skin of her teeth.
This movie has such a realness and such a rawness to it because a lot of the stuff in this movie is one take and it's me having to do it. Everything is just so authentic and full of such empathy and humanity, and I think that that's really special to see in the genre.
You can't become an assassin overnight, and the fact that she throws herself into these situations and sometimes fails, I think gives it a real sense of reality and a fresher quality.
Yeah. The best way I could help the script achieve what I felt it was trying to say was by putting the audience completely in her perspective as much as possible, not always making everything look super slick.
And the other one. Is this for me?
No, no.
Yes, you're very close.
The times when you can hang on a shot, I think it really helps the audience get even more sucked into the story and then raises the stakes and also makes things feel more visceral and more frightening.
The way he tests her and trains her is sometimes quite unorthodox. It's not one of these sort of miracle transformations, which is at the heart of what I love about the film, the sort of brutality and the reality of it. He's not able to turn her into a sort of ninja overnight, but he uses abilities and assets that she already has, and he also puts her into situations and tries to encourage her to be more instinctive.
He kept discounting her and her value. And maybe it was a tactic, or maybe he actually believed it. I think it was probably a bit of both. And so it was up to her proving to him each time, do not discount me and do not like write me off like you think you know me. I am a human being and I'm powerful and I will succeed.
Right, shoot me.
What?
Right here. Control the rhythm section, remember? The rhythm section. Like in music.
We had to do a fight scene in this film that was one take, and so the level of like trust it takes to do that is something that's really intense, because you're not just fighting with the choreography like a dance, you're also having to act in the scene, and it's just a really vulnerable situation to be in.
Boy's character tried to push her limit at the maximum to see what she has. And she jumped on him and tried to put the knife on him. So he realized at that moment, okay, I can do something with her because she has something here, she has some rage. That's a big turning point, story-wise. And also I think she realized she's gonna have to work a lot and it's not that easy to kill someone.
But to be able to put Blake in the fight scene in the kitchen and have her just fight through it and let the camera roll, it really made the scene feel like as real as possible, because it sort of was.
There's things all around that you can use.
So there's this moment like that.
And there's moments where when you're in that, even though everything is choreographed, you kind of have to improvise moments. If something goes a little off and you actually want it to look really authentic and real and raw, you have to kind of improvise. But yeah, that's the scene that I think I'm most proud of.
In that scene, we have Blake's character, Stephanie, who's gonna come to find the Lehman, which is an ex-assassin, and she's gonna have to kill him. But at that stage of the film, she never killed anyone yet.
If he's on his knees and then I just hit him, it just seems like unnecessarily brutal for the character and what we've done.
No contact.
Maybe if I see you reaching for the oxygen.
Yeah.
Then I'm reaching for it too, but you just kind of die first. Because I'm not actually killing you.
Obviously, what's happening here was not what she planned, and she has to improvise. And by luck, she's gonna survive and succeed her mission, but it's really chaotic. Right away, she's in danger. She's in trouble because her hand gets smashed against the glass, so she can't use her right hand. She's losing her gun. She gets half knockout after 5 seconds. That fight tells the story of her practicing to be a killer.
You're never really rooting. When she gets the bad guys, you're not like, yay, she did it. You're like, oh my God, that's really awful. Why did that just happen? And I think that that's the important part of telling the story, is that there's a responsibility to human life. Taufik and I have a fight scene on the bus, and it was the most intense choreography because at this point in the movie, she's gotten better at it, and it's very much life or death.
She starts like a normal person, and at the end of the film, she's gonna become an assassin.
Every scene in this movie is life or death, which is what makes it so tense the whole time.
She starts at rock bottom, and she sort of has to rebuild herself and reclaim her life and find a reason to sort of justify her existence.
There's no one left.